Like any other event of this magnitude, volunteers play probably the most significant role for the success and smooth running of the meet.
One of the things that is important, we need to understand that the contribution of volunteers to this meet over the years has been tremendous. Most of the persons who coach the teams and come with the children from the different parishes, they're not paid by the JT, they're volunteers. To actually make this meet happen, we would not have enough human resource. And there, SagiCorps came on board, and SagiCorps has brought on a number of volunteers.
The spirit of volunteerism is alive and well at SagiCorps. Over these 2 days, we have almost 200 volunteers.
The volunteers sign up by just sending out an email, and then we just get our overwhelming support.
Who are here at the stadium, who work in various different areas to really ensure that the championships run smoothly.
I recognize that they were chosen well because they were chosen for their skill sets and what it is that they could bring to this table to make the meet a success over the years.
Some are working at the finish line, rehydration stops, the medical team.
We have volunteers for PR to ensure that we capture the moment, capture the stars, the future stars of Jamaica.
With that, it is a strong demonstration of volunteerism.
In fact, apart from the JTA paid staff, which is not a large one, everybody else is a volunteer.
We preach giving back to the community, and as a part of the scholarship programs, we encourage them to give back as well.
It says to the younger people in Jamaica that volunteerism has not died, and volunteerism can assist us in realizing our 2030 vision and building the kind of Jamaica that we want it to be.
So I don't think it would be possible without the volunteers, because the volunteers basically put the final pieces to the puzzle.
But what would this championship be without the fans? Certainly, they are the ones that make the championship the spectacle that it certainly is.
So naturally, I'm here supporting the best parish in Jamaica, St. Catherine. Big up to the red team all the way.
We came to represent the parish of St. Elizabeth, and our children did so well.
It's definitely been a long day, but seeing the children coming from the DA level to here, it is really pleasing to see the development and the energy they put out and put everything into the day.
Every race today was very good, and my sister Fisher Holong, she ran exceptionally well.
We did very well, although we didn't make it to some of the finals in the relay, but overall we did very good and I'm proud.
Today was very exciting. It's my second time at the stadium. I really enjoy myself. I really enjoy cheering for my team, especially my little cousin, Rianne Smith. She did a wonderful job. I'm representing my alma mater, Marneyside Primary, in the parish of St. Elizabeth, and I just want to big up all the St. Elizabeth Massive. They did well, and I'm so happy that I'm a part of their team, number one to the world. Win or lose.
Well, I've been here consistently for the past 4 years, and trust me, I'm always excited to come, always excited to see the young talent coming out here to do exceptionally well, because this is Jamaica's future being developed right here. SagiCorps, big up all the time.
The 35th staging of the JTA SagiCorps Championship was deemed a major success, and the St. Andrew deserved to be crowned the champions.
We're overjoyed, trust me, this is long been coming. Last year we had a hiccup on my first try, and winning the second year, I'm elated. And I can tell you, the whole coaching staff, the parish, everyone is happy. The game plan was try to win as many as three classes, under 9, under 11, under 15. We know St. Catherine has always been very dominant in the under 13 section, so we try to maximize our points in other places.
It was even sweeter for the parish of St. Andrew as they boasted the champion boy.
That is added bonus. Trust me, he's very good, very talented individual.
Dushan as a track athlete, he's a very determined young man. This year he take it to the track. He come out early for training. He's the captain of the team. And he tried to motivate others with him.
The JTA SagiCorps Championship was a very competitive championship at the time. I felt very happy and proud of myself that I earned 3 medals.
From training, I said this guy is very much out there, and I expect the best from him. I told him, as in training, that he's one of the best going out in the primary championship.
I could not contain my joy, but I knew that Dushan could do it because I've seen the potential in him, and I know that whatever that he decides on, as long as he's determined, he always come true.
When his name was called, I announced as the overall champion boy. I feel proud. I look at him and I hug him and I pat him and I said, boy, here it is.
And the champion girl came from St. Thomas.
Ramona bringing home this trophy, accolade to St. Thomas is lifting the candles of St. Thomas higher once more.
I like it. I like when our rural children do well.
I, as a little girl growing up, was very energetic and well, active, always moving around the place. The moment you ask her to go and get something, she doesn't walk, she's always running. And Ramaya's journey to school, she has to walk to school in the morning and she has to walk home in the evening.
I won the champion girl 2 times.
Working with her as a sports coordinator started in 2017. And I find her to be a very committed individual. She loves what she does. And with her mother as her strong support, she has been progressing.
Ramaya's love for track has been active for, I can say, probably about 4 years now. But she started like 3 years. The real love for it started 3 years when she discovered she really can do track and field.
I really like track and field.
She started out at the DA. She participated and she won all the races, and that, I think, motivated her from then.
It is a great feeling to know that Ramaya took home the Champion Girls Trophy to the parish of St. Thomas, because as a team, our objective was to come in the top five, but we did not achieve that this year. But the fact that we have gotten the overall champion girl, we are really very proud.
I'd like to thank JTA and Sagicor for coming on board to develop these young talents. Really, talents are there in the primary schools and the prep schools. However, they need encouragement, and that's JTA and Sagicor provides that. And I must commend them. It's a well put together venture.
Sagicor Group really looks forward to continuing with the JTA with this partnership. We think it's something that's really novel. It continues to impact the lives of more than 1,000 athletes every year, and it looks forward to really pushing them and excelling their career when they go to the high school level and even beyond.